I took out my epoxy flow, as I call it. I never did show you this little heat shield I forgot to put on, by the way. But anyway, I took it out. I'm going to do a repaint on it to get it closer to this finish. And at first I found a matte black and I wasn't so sure. Then I found a shop that happened to have the wrinkle black. Every pick I've seen of this online finished looks so close to this. I think it's going to be a really good match. So I'm going to disassemble all this and get to painting. In the meantime, I'm going to show you a much cheaper solution if you just want to buy the epoxy, a much cheaper intake. Anybody that's been following me for a couple of years knows that I'm just going to make an epoxy stubby, but I do have all kinds of leftover parts and brackets from all my old intakes. So I'm going to go ahead and assemble that too while I'm in the process of getting this shield repainted. So all we're talking about here is just your math into your stock stage 2 intake pipe. A little bracket down here, sorry about the gardeners, that little 90 degree bracket right on your same rubber isolator, and you're just going to find the hose that fits right into that spot. And that's a really simple intake. The silicone hose is really easy to cut just with a razor blade. It almost goes through like butter. You just move it a little bit and it just slices right through. Do be careful though, using the hose clamp for a marker like I've shown you before. You want to put your MAF into this hose first. Remember, the new speed one was a little bigger, so this 3-inch hose is a little tight, but you just got to stretch it and work it through and it'll fit. There we go. Now, the full intake that you saw in the last video, I am still happy with it. It actually got better after a day or two of driving. It improved. So this is just a temporary setup, just so I can have something on my car while I do my paint. Just want to show you the final result here. So it's right there. You got actually far more room down here than you do with the other one, just because it places the pipe a little bit differently. I like my clamps on this side for this intake instead of this side than the other one. And the only closed spot is the hose right there. And what you can do is you can swivel your intake up and down on this bolt here, and you can actually raise it or lower it and get it in just the right spot. I got everything tightened. This is actually more solid than the P-Flow. And you're still using your rubber isolator just like the P-Flow. Simple L-bracket. You get that piece of 1/8-inch thick aluminum bar at Home Depot. And it's like a yard long, and you just cut it, bend it over a little 2x4 piece of wood with a mallet, and then just pick your heights and stuff like that. And of course, every intake will have a drawback. This is a little more hot air than P-Flow, but you can also look at it like, how much heat is that one little metal shield really going to help you? You have your vent here, and the heat shield actually only comes in the middle, and the intake's on this side over here. So it's all kind of opinion. If you do want something really cheap, you can do this for about 100 shipped, and maybe 20 shipped for a hose, a couple clamps for $5, and you can get a pretty good intake. I do want to mention, if you go to the Mark 6 Golf forums, you'll find a intake technical understanding thread. It's a sticky in the GTI engine section. I did a lot of logs on this exact intake on my 2011, and this was one of the top flowers of every intake that was in that whole thread. I think my peak on this was 260 grams per second. I think it's grams, I don't know. Gallons per second, whatever it is. But this had one of the highest flows of every intake that's in that testing in there. So there's no denying that it flows. It's just a question of if it's going to be pulling in too much hot air. This is really the most direct intake you can get. And I do like it sometimes. It's so instant when you step on the throttle. Since I do have the light proper, I just want to show you the final. Oh, you might see something here. I took off the tints last night. I really like orange, and I kind of missed it, to be honest, so I peeled them off, alcoholed them up, and cleaned them up. Anyway, here's the grill. I still love the grill. No regrets, no plans on changing it. I love the black center and the nice LED headlights. Really top it off. If it didn't have these fancy headlights, it might look a little boring, but with the DRLs and the LEDs all there, it really tops off this mean look. And I decided to flip the car around to show you the rear, final, everything done. the carbon fiber inlay is the difference here in the last ones. Really liking that GTI still. Blends in real nice. I'm just loving the whole look of the car now. My cosmetics are done. Sort of like the headlights up front. If this car didn't have the LED tails, it would also, to me, look pretty boring and lame. It's just the whole package deal. Fancy lights front and rear, the badges that all come together to me to make the look I'm trying to achieve.